Today we're biting into local specialties at Seogwipo Hyangto 5-Day Market on the south of Jeju Island. It's our first time at this traditional market. We also try some of their quintessential Korean street food. Hope you enjoy this episode of 9 Days on Jeju Island with Miss Mina and Mommy Oh.
안녕 친구! Today, Mommy Oh and I are checking out a 5-day market. This market opens on the 4th and 9th each month. So anything with 4 and 9 in it. The 4th, 9th, 14th, 19th, 24th, 29th, like that.
There are multiple entrances. We approach the fruity aisle, lined up with baskets of grapes, cherries, apples, Korean melons, and of course, halabong. Across the fruit section is a honey stall and pajamas. Hey! Crackers, candy, cookies, and all the crunchies. A crew of corn steam bathing. This street food vendor also sells waffles, corn dogs, skewered meats, and pondaegi, steamed silkworm pupae.
오늘은 떡볶이 맛 먹고 싶어. 맛있는 떡볶이하고 튀김.
On the search for 떡볶이 and 튀김, we pass by a medley of side dishes, such as cucumber kimchi. Aha! Called bingtteok, these are Jeju-style buckwheat pancakes.
She fills in the gaps. Oh, and she's letting them cool down on the wooden board.
Each pancake is filled with salted radish and sesame seeds, then rolled up into a shape that is similar to a burrito, except the ends are pressed and flattened instead of tucked in.
Alright, three of these is 2001.
메밀만 들어가는 거래. 밀가루 이런 거하고 믹스 안 하고.
The accompanying sauce contains soy sauce, water, sesame seeds, and scallion. Whoop-de-doo!
And you see, when you touch it, it's not oily at all. You know, this is our breakfast, and I'm glad we started with this. Some street food, it tends to be oily, but this one is not. So it feels like a healthier type of street food. I've never seen this being sold in Seoul, and we've been to many markets. Local specialty. All right, let's have another one.
네, 여기를 쏟아 나오니까 이걸 하고 여기를 잡고.
Oh, that's a good idea. I'm gonna ask you to feed me then. 하나 It tastes awesomely sesame oily, and that's because she adds sesame oil in the batter and in the filling, and we put it in the sauce. So it's sesame oil times three. Sesame, three, triple. So there's a woman who came and ordered to go, and then they put this in the shoebox as a to-go box. Crack me up.
Behind us is a shop selling lingerie and jammies. Across the camo pants and fishing vests is a casual restaurant called Ilbonji Shikdang. They serve noodles, blood sausage, chicken feet, and hot soup with rice with various meats.
We're gonna keep walking, see what other food options there are. This whole side is lined with restaurants.
This row of eateries are bookended by a furniture shop. Oh yes, traditional Korean drawers and tables.
It looks like we have entered the seafood section.
This area may be dedicated to seafood, but the rows upon rows of light bulbs capture my attention more. Holy wow, the patience to peel so much garlic.
Oh, we have samples. 뭐예요?
치즈.
Look at how golden that is. Golden brown. Mmm. Love cheese. Love the taste. Love the texture.
Vegetables. Cut and salted ponytail radish ready for use. Mommy Oh says it's no easy task to prep so many.
이거 총각김치 담그는 거야.
떡볶이! Mommy Oh, your wish is gonna come true. There's egg in that, as well as fish cake. Each one of these is 700 won. Alright, so you get a tray and then you pick the ones you want. Let's get one of these guys. Is that ojigo?
Mm-hmm.
Squid. Oh yeah, let's get one of those. Mm-hmm. So textured. Sweet potato. Oh yeah. It looks like it has some sugar on that. 계란이에요? Ah, I love how open kitchen it is. So one serving is 3,500 won. We got a couple sticks of the duck, one egg, and I also see some fish cake.
This stall provides a dining area, and they put their chopsticks in a cut bottle. A cup of fish cake soup is complimentary, a common happening for stalls that sell omuk.
Mommy is gonna cut the kimmari tigim. Ooh, that one oozed out. It's like, meh. Wow.
The outside, it looks a little pimply. Mmm, that's good. The ends are extra crispier.
Gotta love how that one strand of noodle hangs out so confidently.
Now the surface of it is made of seaweed. This time, let's try the sweet potato. Tastes like sweet potato, which is always a good thing. Fried vegetables.
Wow. They put what I like.
They put what you like, but what do they put in?
Perilla leaves.
Oh.
No, not perilla. Sesame leaves.
Some of the edges are so crispy.
Tastes oily and is oily. Their napkins are star-studded and bumpy, like a basketball.
My favorite tea game is the kimbari tea game. What's your favorite tea game here?
Vegetable tea game.
Now let's find out, is this tteokbokki sweet or not? It's a little sweet, but it's more spicy than sweet.
A little sweet, but not too much. 어떤 떡볶이는 너무 달잖아.
This time let's try the fish cake.
이 떡볶이가 특별한 게 다른 거는 이렇게 얇게 떡볶이 떡으로 나온 거 얇은 거 그걸 쓰는데 이거는 진짜 큰 떡 이렇게 큰 거를 이렇게 이렇게 쓸어서 한 거야. 맛있다 떡볶이. 또 먹자 떡볶이. 다시 오자 떡볶이.
Tomio loves this tteokbokki. If you want more flavor, you can always dip your food into the tteokbokki sauce. Now, this is called koguma tteokbokki. It's not bad. It tastes like what it sounds like, koguma and tteokbokki. Actually, the more I eat this tteokbokki, it's getting sweeter and sweeter. Here's what I think happened. When we ate the tteokbokki, the oil coated our tongue, so the tteokbokki didn't taste as sweet. But now like I drank some of the fish cake soup and had the tteokbokki, and now the sweetness is more apparent.
And because, you know, the soup, it's a little salty.
Doesn't salt make you taste sweet more?
Yeah.
That's what they say. Food is chemistry. The order in which you eat things will affect the flavor.
By the way, the stall we ate at is called Obogi.
I need dessert.
Dessert.
On the mission to find dessert, we witness more Korean side dishes. Rows of cucumber and stacks of traditional earthenware jars.
Here they sell curtains. We have more curtains here.
Patjuk, Korean red bean porridge for 5,000 won per bowl. This one's got plenty of rice.
Yeah, donuts.
This is donuts, you guys. I've never seen anything like this.
Donkatsu.
Ah, donkatsu예요?
Yeah.
Have you ever seen donkatsu that is green? And this is a red one. The vendor was telling me it's made of beet. That's where the coloring comes from. Do you hear that? Super crunchy. Yes. And it's savory, not sweet. Actually, it's a little bit sweet. I feel it there. I feel a little bit.
Walking past clothing stalls, we arrive to an ocean of side dishes. And these plates look like boats. Samples galore. To the right is seasoned dried shrimp. Dried pollock skin. Pollock is a type of fish. Let's try it.
Oh, when you bite into that, I feel like there's like an oil that oozes out of it.
A pile of dried fish seasoned with almonds and pumpkin seeds. The name of this shop is Kibom Sangwe.
Alright, so each of these is 5,000 won, and Mommy-o decided I'm gonna get it. This is soup with the injeon meat. Right, the outside is covered in red bean.
So soft.
속에 팍 들었어.
Mmm. 오메기떡, I'll see you next time we are in Jeju. Salt.
We are gonna head back to the car and stop by the falls. It looks like the parking lot has gotten competitive.
About 15 minutes by car is a Cheonjeon waterfall. Tickets were 2,000 won per adult. You know you're on Jeju Island when you see stone grandfathers. I imitated their pose, and people thought I was announcing pregnancy.
I would say if you are in the area, you can stop by, but it's not something that you'd want to drive like an hour, like a crazy amount of time to get here.
On the way back to the hotel, I stopped by Bottle and Bowl to pick up a salad for dinner. They also serve smoothie bowls and cold-pressed juice. This salad's got tomatoes, olives, kidney beans, chickpea, cucumber, purple cabbage, boiled egg, and mixed greens. Aha! The avocado is topped off with chia seeds and hemp hearts. This ain't no wimpy salad.
I'm taking a little break from video editing. I start to crave some dessert. So we're gonna have the omegi deok, the leftover ones. We brought them back to the hotel with us. I was about to eat these without filming it. But you know what I realized? When Mommy O was feeding me these, I didn't get to touch it myself with my fingers. Thing is, when you touch it with your fingers, this is part of the experience. It's so fleshy. Oh, and the outside is sticky. So when you pick it up, your fingers just, wow, go into the deok. It moves down like a stalactite. It's a very slow drip, a chewy drip. See? Don't worry, I caught it. Very sticky. You do not want to drop this on your carpet. And the inside, we have red bean paste, which is the sweetest part of this omegi deok. Because the outside, the exterior is covered with red beans. It's almost like when you see a wall that is covered in like pebbles, you know, those smooth stones. It looks like that. That's what it reminds me of. Time to continue editing. Bye bye!
In the next and final episode of 9 Days on Jeju Island, our featured guests include kabocha squash with dignified yummy crowns, an open-faced sandwich with poached egg, and this and that. Remember to subscribe and hit that notification bell. For food and travel around the world, check out my other channel, Miss Mina. To relax at night, listen to ASMR Bedtime with Miss Mina. We read, crunch, crinkle, and more. In the sunset's gold. 안녕, 친구.
It's past 10:30 a.m. It was not too difficult to find parking. If it gets closer to 12 noon, I imagine competitive parking. Take a breath. It smells a little fruity.
Yeah. Huh?
And there's old school Korean music playing in the background. There's actually a vendor selling cassette tapes.
Nuts, almonds. We still have almonds, so we won't buy that yet.
Okay, so I forgot what I was gonna say.
We have a street food stall. Omuk, fish cake, sausage, corn dog, and we have skewered chicken. One, two, three kinds, and then we're gonna get tteokbokki.
Ooh, look at it. Ooze out when you cut it. Barely oozes out and goes back in when you let go of the scissor pressure.
맛있는 팥죽 있으면 좋겠지.
Oh yeah, 팥죽 sounds good. Mm-hmm. Right ahead we have child bait. A bunch of toys just kind of sticking out into the pedestrian walkway. Meow! Aw, so cute! Meow!
Yeah,